fourth annual Black History Program. We appreciate you coming tonight. We're excited to see what the kids are going to do. They've been working hard, and it's a celebration of Black history, contributions of African Americans to our country. We're excited about celebrating that with our students and with you this evening, and we're gonna have a great time. So thank you for coming to our Black History Program. We're looking forward to celebrating with you. I'm Kevin, I'm the principal here at Primary North, and we appreciate as well as with the teachers your support of our school. So tonight we're gonna celebrate Black history, and we appreciate you doing that with us, and we're gonna have a great time with the kids. So with no further ado, we welcome you to our fourth annual Black History Celebration. We'll start with our North Node, so give them a round of applause.
Lift every voice and sing to earth and heaven. punishment of achievement by African Americans and others in our country. It is a time for recognizing the central role of blacks in U.S. history. The events grew out of Mitchell History Week, the brainchild of noted history Dr. Carter G. Woodson and other prominent African Americans. Winston chose February because the month contained the birthdays of both Abraham Lincoln and Frederick Douglass, two well-known men whose historic achievements African Americans already celebrated. Lincoln's birthday was February because Douglas, a former slave, hadn't known his actual birthday but had marked the occasion on February 14th.
With the rise of civil rights and black power movements in the 1960s, young African Americans on college campuses were becoming increasingly conscious of the historic importance of their experience. In 1976, on the 50th anniversary of the first Negro History Week, the association officially made the shift to Black History Month.
Did you know President Gerald Ford in that same year, 1976, began the tradition saying the celebration enabled people to seize the opportunity to honor the too often neglected accomplishment of Black Americans in every area of their memory. Throughout our history, Ronald Reagan's first Black History Month proclamation stated that understanding the history of Black Americans is a key to understanding the strength of our nation.
When Jesus said,
country, the United States of America. African Americans have served in every U.S. military conflict, both foreign and domestic. The very soul of African Americans are deeply rooted in different forms of science, entertainment, education, and literature. Tonight, we'll open our history books and take a glimpse.
Black colleges have been serving African Americans since before the American Civil War. The first higher education institution for blacks was founded in Cheney, Pennsylvania in 1837. It was followed by two other black institutions, Lincoln University in Pennsylvania and Wilberforce University in Ohio in 1856. Schools such as Central State, Howard University, Morehouse, Tuskegee, and Spelman also began with the purpose of providing black youths who were largely prevented due to racial discrimination from attending established colleges and universities a chance to continue their education. In the beginning of the 1900s, as some colleges began to admit black students in the North, African American students on campus formed study groups to support one another. Out of these groups, some of the first historically black fraternities and sororities were born. Please join us as we celebrate historically black colleges, HBCU bands, and the Divine Nine sororities and fraternities. All right, we are now going to recognize each fraternity and sorority. We would like you to stand if you are a member of one of these groups. Please stand when we call the organization's name. First, Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity, founded in 1906 at Cornell University. Anyone, any alphas here? Next, Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, founded in 1908 at Howard University. AKAs, any AKAs here? Please stand. Next we have Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity, founded in 1911 at Indiana University. Any Kappas?
There you go.
Omega Psi Phi, Omega Psi Phi Fraternity, founded in 1911 at Howard University. Omega Psi Phi, anyone? Okay, Delta Sigma Theta Sorority, founded in 1913 at Howard University. Any Deltas? There we go. Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity, founded in 1914 at Howard University. Any Sigmas? Zeta Phi Beta Sorority, founded in 1920. Zeta Phi Beta Sorority, any Zetas? Sigma Gamma Rho Sorority, founded in 1922 at Butler University. Any Sigma Gamma Rho? Finally, Iota Phi Theta Fraternity, founded in 1963 at Morgan State University. Any Iotas? All right, let's give a round of applause for our black fraternities and sororities, HBCUs, and for the kids. Here we go, we're out of here. Come on, kids. Go ahead, go ahead. Round of applause.
When company comes, but I laugh, ha ha, and eat well and grow strong. My people, my late friends, the night is beautiful, so are the faces of my people. The stars are beautiful, so are the eyes of my people. Beautiful also is the sun. Beautiful also is the sun. Beautiful also is the souls of my people. Thank you.
Today is a day we all sing in honor of Martin Luther King. Wherever people fight to be free, his name is remembered with dignity. When black people were treated right, he stood strong to lead the fight. He fought with love, not guns or darts. He changed people's minds and their hearts. But some people didn't like his words. He was taken away to a better world. Yet his dream lives on where all can be free. When we knock down the walls between you and me, Martin Luther King's life did not last, but his dream and his fear are free at last.
Thank you.
As the 20th century gets underway, great American music in the new form of jazz is born. Enjoy the 1933 legendary jazz hit by Duke Ellington, It Don't Mean a Thing. First graders.
Thank you.
Did you know that The Twist was first recorded in Cincinnati and that James Brown started his career in Cincinnati with King Records? From 1943 to 1971, King Records forever changed American music. Owner Sid Nathan gave the world bluegrass, R&B, rock and roll, doo-wop, country, soul, and funk. With stars from James Brown to the Stanley Brothers, Cincinnati's King Records revolutionized the music industry. King Records was founded in Cincinnati in the 1940s. By the end of the 1950s, it became one of the six largest record companies in the country with more than 400 employees. King Records was one of the first companies in Cincinnati having African Americans and whites working side by side. Now, from King Records, help me welcome the James Brown Dancers with I Got the Feeling. With us tonight, please welcome, here's the mic, here's, please welcome Don Cornelius.
Yeah.
Maze, featuring Frankie Beverly. I'm the soul of Ben Jackson, and now, here is your host, Don Cornelius.
Program which aired in syndication from October 2nd, 1971 to March 27th, 2006. In its 75-year history, the show primarily featured performances by R&B, dance, and pop, and hip-hop artists, although funk, jazz, disco, and gospel artists also appeared. Soul Train was a time to sit down and dream for an hour about being a part of a big TV show. It was great to see people of color, big afros, and super cool dancers. Then you will hear those closing words. I'm Don Cornelius, and it's always important to wish you peace, love, and soul.
Woo, get it, girl.
keep the light bulb burning. Engineer and inventor Louis Latimer was born 1848 to parents who quit slavery. Thomas Edison is recognized as the inventor of the light bulb, but African-American inventor Louis Latimer played an important role in its development. In 1881, Latimer, along with Joseph Nichols, invented a light bulb with a carbon filament and improvement on Thomas Edison's original paper filament, which burned out quickly. Latimer sold the patent to the United States Electric Company in 1881. He received a second patent on January 17, 1882 for the process and manufacturing carbons and improved method for the production of light bulb carbon filaments. Latimer learned the art of mechanical drawing while working at a patent firm. Over the course of his career as a draftsman, Latimer worked closely with Thomas Edison and Alexander Graham Bell, in addition to designing his own inventions. Thank you.
Lewitt Morgan, born 1877 to 1963. In 1914, Morgan invented a safety hood. It made polluted air more breathable. The invention was an early version of the gas masks later used in World War I to protect soldiers from poison gas. Gilbert Morgan also invented a safety and smoke protection device after seeing firefighters struggling on the smoke. They encountered in the line of duty his device used a wet sponge to filter out smoke and cool the air. It saved countless lives. Morgan is also known for patenting the traffic signal in 1923. Around the turn of the century, cars, bicycle, horse-drawn vehicles, and pedestrians all had to share the road. It was often quite dangerous. Morgan's traffic signal was the first to feature three commands instead of two, which controlled traffic more effectively. He sold the patent rights to General Electric for $40,000, a huge sum at the time.
History program. Inventor Alexander Miles was born in the late 1830s and 1918s. Early elevators were different from the mostly automated devices we are familiar with today. Passengers had to manually open and close the elevator doors, as well as the door link to the elevator shaft. If anyone forgot to close the shaft door, other passengers could fall down the shaft when expecting to step into the elevator. Miles invented a mechanism that triggered the shaft doors to open and close along with the elevator doors, making the ride safer. The elevators we ride today still feature automatic shaft doors, similar to the invention Miles patented in 1887.
Marie Van Brittain Brown, born 1922 to 1999. Let's talk about home security. Back in 1966, the idea for a home surveillance device seemed almost unthinkable. That was the year African-American inventor Marie Van Brittain Brown and her husband, Ab Brown, applied for a Benson patent for a closed-circuit television security system. The forerunner to the modern home security system. Brown's system had a set of four peepholes and a camera that could slide up and down to look out each one. Anything the camera picked up would appear on the monitor. An additional feature of Brown's invention was that a person could also unlock a door with a remote control. A female black inventor far ahead of her time, Marie Van Brittain Brown created an invention that was the first in a long string of home security inventions that continue to flood the market today.
Mm-hmm. for IBM, where he led the team that designed the ISA bus, the hardware interface that allows multiple devices like printers, modems, and keyboards to be plugged into a computer. This innovation helped pave the way for the personal computers using office business settings. Dean also helped develop the first color computer monitor. Today, the computer scientist holds three of the company's original 9 patents and more than 20 overall.
Boston was a forerunner of the boy band craze of the 1980s and 90s. Please help me welcome New Edition.
Probe. She patented that invention in 1988 and
today, she's recognized as the first female African-American doctor to receive a medical patent.
James E. West, born 1931, studied physics at Temple University and entered at Bell Labs during his summers. In 1957, West went to work at Bell Labs. He and fellow scientist Gerhard M. Sigler developed an inexpensive, compact, and highly sensitive microscope, which they patented in
1962.
Today, 90% of microphones use their technology, including those in cell phones, laptops, screen monitors, and hearing aids.
And I'm Elsa, reporting on Civil Rights and you.
Get the mic. Go read.
The Civil Rights Act of 1964 was one of the most important civil rights laws in the history of the United States. It outlawed discrimination, ended racial segregation, and protected the voting rights of minorities and women.
The African-American civil rights movement was an ongoing fight for racial equality that took place for over 100 years after the Civil War. Leaders such as Martin Luther King Jr., Booker T. Washington, and Rosa Parks paved the way for nonviolent protests, which led to changes in the law. I am very grateful.
Me too. Let's ask some PN students about the Civil Rights Act of 1964.
Because of the Civil Rights Act, all Americans are allowed to eat at public restaurants, use hotels, and public transportation.
People can be whatever they want to be. I can get a good education and be a chemist like my nana.
My best friend and I can live on the same street. We play sports and go to school together.
Now you have it. Thanks for sticking around. We're going to have one last song for you tonight. This is called A Place in the Sun by Stevie Wonder.
Thank you so much for celebrating. Before you leave, please don't leave real quick. Thank you so much for celebrating African American history with us and Black History Month. We love that with our kids, to have them perform and to share their talents with you. Before we leave, I would like to recognize some people that have planned this event, and I'd like to have them come up real quick. So first, our art teacher, who's involved with several dance groups and organizing, Katie Labmeyer. Is Katie Labmeyer here? Come on out, Katie. We'll give her a round of applause. We started planning back in November, and they've been at all the meetings and working with us. So Katie, where's Katie Labmeyer? She's coming. Okay, let's go with our music teacher, Emily Jordan. She, of course, did all the songs and organizing. Our choir, here's some flowers. Thank you. We have Mrs. Green, Sharon Green. She did all of our scripts, all of the speaking parts. Mrs. Green did all the decoration back here. She's an amazing woman. Of course, her husband helped us. Thank you, Larry. But Sharon Green is a central piece of our African-American history program each year. So Mrs. Green, here's some flowers for you. God bless you. Thank you so much. Next, we'd like to recognize, is Katie Labmeyer here? Katie, come on out. She's our art teacher. She made our fraternity signs. She is planning the dance group, the James Brown group. So Katie is our art teacher. Thank you for all your work. Thank you so much. All of our volunteers were coordinated by Rebecca Dennis. She's one of our kindergarten teachers. So come on out, Mrs. Dennis. We appreciate you. Mrs. Dennis. Thank you. We also have our, on the piano, Mrs. Hudak. Mrs. Hudak, if you can come on up, she's our librarian. And she helps with our music. We appreciate you, Cindy, thank you so much. We appreciate you. Also, we have Mr. Phillips. He's one of our classroom assistants. Mr. Phillips right here. He sang for us. He also set up our sound system. We appreciate his father, Mr. Phillips, for helping us. I don't have any flowers, but I will give you a fist bump. Fist bump. There you go. All right. All right. Also, we have, Katie, Sharon, Emily, Rebecca, Cindy. We have two high school students that came down from the drill team, and they worked with our James Brown dancers on the choreography. So are Naomi and Amaya, are you here? Come on out. Naomi, we have some flowers for you. Thank you. And she came to every practice and choreographed the James Brown dance, so we appreciate you, Naomi. Thank you so much.